And with us now from her home is Chrissy Metz. Good to see you. How are you?
Good to see you. Thanks for having me. I'm so happy to be here.
I know, and it's such a perfect show because, as I said, so many of us see you as our friend in our heads. I mean, we just follow everything, of course, the career and the music, but just even your personal life. And I'm not one to go, you know, digging into the tabloids to find out what's going on. So I figured I'll go to the source here. Chrissy, I don't know if you know, I kept my pregnancy private for 32 weeks. It was until I could not hide it anymore. And I've been recently told that you have found the love of your life and that people are talking about some ring on your finger, your boyfriend Bradley. So cute together. Congratulations. Not on engagement, because I don't know if that's real or not. I'm talking about congratulations on finding this great love in your life. Tell me all about him.
Thank you. Yeah, his name is Bradley, and we met, interestingly enough, on Bumble over quarantine.
The dating site. Bumble, the dating site?
Yes. People couldn't believe that I was on, and it was, for me, you know, I was in Nashville. We had only planned on being there for a couple weeks, my best friend and I, and I was like, oh, why not? And then, of course, as I come to see his profile and I just see his picture and I'm like, I really want to know him. Like, I feel like I either know him or I want to know him. And
was that his profile shot? We just showed a picture of him with some sun. So did he have like the cool guy profile shot? What was it?
It was a really sweet sort of business shot. He was sitting in a blazer, like on a cool couch, you know, just not obnoxious, but not like trying too hard, you know. it was good. It was perfect. That shot was actually taken when we went to Joshua Tree by moi. So I'm a photographer now too. I'm not. We ended up chatting about music because he's been in the music business as well for many, many years. And it turns out we know all the same people. We have all the same friends.
That's so crazy. So you went on this app or this dating site. Did you put your real name and picture up?
I did.
You did? Did anyone try to convince you not to do that? Because as I said, I'm your best friend in my head. So I would have said, best friend, I don't know if we should put your picture on the site. Don't we want him to like you before he knows you're Chrissy Metz?
Yes. However, I mean, I think so much, especially now in the days of online dating, you want to know what you're getting into. And
that's
if
true.
I want to see his picture and I want to see what he looks like, I feel like it's only fair that I would do the same. So, and who, for whomever I would potentially match with. And, you know, I didn't put I don't think I put anything on my profile, maybe just like a line or two. And I feel like it sort of weeds out the people who are interested in the idea of me or actually interested in getting to know me. And he definitely was such a gentleman in getting to know me and never even spoke about the show for like probably a couple weeks while we were texting and, you know, just FaceTiming each other. So it was nice. He did all the right things.
He did all the right things. Right. So it's been what now? How long you been together?
Almost 7 months.
Oh, that's a long time. I mean, considering like for an online dating, you know, I don't want to say hookup because I don't know what happened on the date. I'm just going to say.
No. It definitely was, feels like an old sort of romantic courtship in that, you know, we didn't kiss for quite some time. We were having social distance dates, you know, this is when we were heading back to LA, safely. And, we did things very slowly and very sweetly. And I think that's such a difference in previous relationships that you like really get to know one another. Mm-hmm. And we don't really do that very often anymore.
I like that, but that's true. You don't get to, you kind of rush in and rush out, which is why, as I said, and I don't want you to think I'm trying to bait you to find out if you're engaged or not, which is why go ahead. What do you want to tell me?
No, I was going to show you, this is the actual ring that, it's a honeycomb ring. I love bees. And so he bought it for me for Christmas. And so when paparazzi photographed me in it, I was like, this could not look more different than an actual engagement ring. But they don't know that from, you know, 100 yards away. So no, I'm not engaged. This is not an engagement ring. However, it was a gift from him.
Okay, I love it. So let me see. It is a huge, it's a beehive, a honeycomb. Now imagine if that were a diamond. Bradley, with the pressure on him now.
Holy smokes. I was thinking like, this is bigger, like the width is bigger than Beyonce or, you know, Kim Kardashian, like ridiculous. Yeah. I wouldn't want to ring this big know-how. Like, this is crazy.
I know your character, Kate, is an aspiring singer. You are already a successful singer, a songwriter. You performed at the Academy Awards in 2020, and now you're preparing for the release of your debut album. That is a major moment.
Yeah, it's kind of it's even crazy to hear you say it. I'm like, oh my gosh, I am. And I keep getting the tracks back from the producers, and I'm like, wow, this is actually really happening and something that I wanted forever. Music was my first love, and I was just so afraid to even pursue it. And so now that I feel more vulnerable than ever and able to express clearly my heart sort of out to the world, I'm just really excited about it. And it's nice and important for me to be creative.
How much does being in love now influence? I mean, I imagine you've been writing these songs in your head for this debut album, and now 7 months in love, did you have to say, wait a minute, let me add a track 11, you know, with this new me and these new feelings that are inside me?
Well, I do try to write. Every time we set up a write, I want to write from what I'm experiencing and what I'm feeling, because I feel like that is authentic. And then I don't want to sing somebody else's songs, because I want it to come from a real place. Not that I can't relate to other songs. However, when I first couple dates, and maybe at the second month in of dating Bradley, we got into a song right. And so we wrote a really cool song called New Love, and
together
it's fun.
Okay. It's, you know what? I don't normally ask for favors publicly, but I'm going to put you on the spot. I'm going to need the two of you to come and perform this together. Once the album is out, you promised me that you and Bradley will do a special exclusive performance. Do not listen.
No, listen, we didn't write it together, and he wouldn't probably never feel comfortable. But should we ever write a song together, you have the exclusive.
Oh, then you blocked me in.
Song.
Okay, well then then you perform alone, and he can be in the background on the tambourine. I don't care what it is.
Okay, you got it.
I need you here. I need to see that performance. Well, congratulations on a new season of This Is Us and the album. I can't wait to have it and to hear it. And to have you in studio performing. Thank you so much, Chrissy.
Love that. Thank you so much. Have a great day.
Okay. Well, you know what? And by the way, This Is Us airs Tuesday nights on NBC.